A hash function can be applied to a block of data of any size. A hash function produces an output of fixed size, typically in the range of 128 bits to 512 bits. It should be very efficient to compute a hash of an input. For a given hash value, it should be computationally infeasible to find the input so that the hash matches the given hash value. That is, a hash function should be a one-way function. Given input data, say M1, it should be computationally infeasible to find another input value, say M2, that is not equal to M1, such that they have the same hash value. This is the weak collision-resistant property. The strong collision-resistant property is such that it should be computationally infeasible to find different inputs, M1 not equal to M2, such that they have the same hash value. The first three properties make hash functions practical for security applications. In particular, it can handle data of any size and it's very efficient to compute a hash. The one-way property says that it is quite easy to compute a hash value given a message, but it is virtually impossible to find the original input message given a hash value. This property is very important for message authentication. For example, we can authenticate a message by hashing a secret value together with the message. The secret is not sent, the hash and the message is sent. If the hash function is not one way, then the attacker, being able to intercept the hash value that's being transmitted, he can then find the input that computes the hash value, and the input would include the secret value. That is, the attacker would be able to obtain the secret value. Therefore, this one-way property is extremely important. The weak collision-resistant property says that for a given message, it is not possible to find a different message, such that it will have the same hash value as the given message. This is a very important property to ensure message integrity. Now let's take a closer look at this weak collision-resistant property. Suppose when the sender sends a message to the receiver, he wants to ensure the integrity of the message. So the sender sends a message along with the encrypted hash code of the message. Now an attacker can intercept the message and the encrypted hash code that's being transmitted. Given the message, the attacker can also compute the hash code. Of course, this hash code is not encrypted because the attacker does not have the key. Then, if the weak collision-resistant property is not true, the attacker will be able to find another message such that its hash value is the same as the hash value of the original message. Then the attacker simply forwards to the receiver the forged message along with the original encrypted hash code. The receiver will not be able to tell that the message has been modified by the attacker because the forged message has exactly the same hash value as the original message. The strong collision-resistant property says that it is not possible to find any pair of two different messages so that they have the same hash value. It should be obvious that the strong collision-resistant property implies the weak collision-resistant property. The weak collision-resistant property means that the hash function is collision-resistant only to the specific given input messages, whereas the strong collision-resistant property means that the hash function is collision-resistant to any pair of different messages. Therefore, this is a stronger property, and it implies the weaker property. The strong collision-resistant property provides strong message authenticity and integrity protection. Let's take a look at an example. Suppose Bob did some work for Alice, and he wants Alice to pay him later. So he can draft a IOU message and ask Alice to sign and then agree to pay for it. To sign the message, Alice will hash the IOU message and then sign the hash using her private key. This would prove that Alice authorized the IOU message. In other words, Alice would agree to pay this amount later. In a later day, Bob can present this IOU message along with the signature to Alice or Alice's bank to get the money. Now suppose the strong collision-resistant property is not true. That would mean that Bob can find two different messages, one with a smaller dollar amount. For example, this small amount can be just one installment of Alice's payment to Bob. And the larger amount would be several times the amount of money that Alice owes Bob. And if these two messages have the same hash value, then Bob can present the message with a small amount to Alice and have Alice sign it. Then later day, Bob can present a signature with a different message, that is, the message with a larger amount, and ask Alice to pay for it. And because these two different messages have the same hash value, Alice cannot deny that she has signed it. That means Alice cannot deny that she had agreed to pay this larger amount.